Sheep of his pasture. friends, welcome. It's great to connect with you like this. It's amazing to gather together from our homes, and it's fantastic that we can share in this celebration. You can gather, I'm excited, yeah? Because it's our first Advent Sunday. Christmas is here. Can you believe it? Listen, we even have an Advent train, but it's not quite ready yet. It will appear next week because it's only got the number 1 through to the number 24. So there's no 29 on there for the 29th of November, if you're watching this on Sunday. So that will come out next week as we journey through Advent. That means the 29th, it's 26 big sleeps till Christmas Day. Wow!
And I'm excited too, although I show it in a different way. I'm excited to journey with you through Advent, because Advent is all about a journey.
That's why it's great to have a train, the Polar Express.
It's a journey of hoping and waiting and expecting in anticipation of what Christmas Day means for us. Mm. We thank God, don't we, for the greatest gift that the world has ever seen, Jesus Christ, as we remember that he came, that he comes, and that he will come again. There will be a second Advent.
Amen. Mm. And this service is about hoping and declaring. And on that first Christmas, the angels declared in the heavens, "Glory to God in the highest." I remember hearing a story about something to do with that. There was a town, and this town had decorated the shops. They'd got lights in the streets. They'd got a big tree in the town square. And across the main street, there was a big banner in lights that echoed the song of the angels. Glory to God in the highest, in big letters that were to light up. Well, the day came when it was the big celebration, and hundreds met in the town ready for the lights to come on. But what had happened was the light for the letter E in the word highest had been disconnected and not put in properly, so it wasn't working. So when the countdown happened and people cheered and shouted and the music started, the lights lit up and said, "Glory to God in the high street." Well, friends, that's what we're doing here, aren't we?
Yes.
It's what you're doing there as we connect from each other's homes in worship. It's great that the angels sing glory to God in the highest, but the message can't be left up there, can it? We need to declare that message down here on planet Earth, in the high streets of our lives, in the high street of your life, in our 24/7 everyday living, connecting with others and shining for God. And as we do so, we bring glory to him, as the angels did.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's do that as we sing together a wonderful carol about the angels. Hark the herald angels sing. Now, last year, we taught our friends at Norwich Citadel the sign language for the refrain. Now, do you remember?
Yes, I think I do. I hope you remember at home, and those of you who are joining with us from other places, you can learn the sign language just for the refrain of Hark the Herald. Hark, do it with us. Hark the herald, that's like a trumpet. Herald,
angels,
that's like wings. Sing, glory to the new born king. That's it. Let's try that again, because I'm trying to remember it myself. Right, go. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the new born king. So have a go at that. If you're not sure what it is, make up your own and just do some language, sign language to that brilliant carol.
As we sing, you'll see members of our songsters, our choir here from Norwich Citadel, and they're singing with a brass group from our headquarters in London. We're then going to listen to a scripture reading from Joe and Jan, which will then be followed by a wonderful Advent song from our virtual worship group called Emmanuel. And then we're going to have a prayer from an angel, Angel Bryony, one of our young people here.
So friends, let the celebration begin, and let there be a real excitement in your home and in your heart as we declare our faith. Hark the herald. Yeah, you've got the rest, haven't you? As we sing about Jesus and exercise with sign language and worship together. Glory to God in the highest and in the high street.
Isaiah chapter 9. Here is the word of God.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given.
And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing it and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forevermore.
The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Lord Jesus, light of the world, shine into our hearts, we pray, and drive away darkness and sadness. Help us to see by your light the way we should go, and please give us all that we need to walk that way, day by day. We rejoice with the angels and declare, glory to God in the highest, and peace to all people. Amen.
Well, that was special, wasn't it? Yeah. To be able to worship together like that. And I hope you feel energised and lifted in your spirits and you feel better about yourself and life and faith and the place that God has in our lives today.
Friends, one of my favourite carols says, the hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. We can bring our hopes and our fears to God. And so just now, we pray today for those who are poorly in hospital, for those who have been bereaved in recent days. We also remember and pray for all those working in the NHS and the community care, and for key workers serving others. And we ourselves bring our hopes and our fears and say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Amen. Mm. Coronavirus means that Christmas is going to be very different this year. It's still going to happen, so don't get worried, children and young people and well, all of us. It's still going to happen, which is great, but it will be unusual. It will be slightly different. It will be sometimes strange, uncomfortable, but unique. But you know, those characteristics, those very words describe something of the first Christmas event, don't they? Strange, uncomfortable, unusual, different, but unique.
Absolutely, there was nothing normal about that first Christmas. Angels singing, shepherds running, a baby in the straw, and wise men journeying on camels. That doesn't happen usually, does it? So as we sing carols and tell the story again, we thank God that, as John puts it, the Word became flesh. The light came into the world. God moved into our neighbourhood. God with us.
The birth of Jesus is the most extraordinary, the most important event in the whole of history. At one moment in time, the infinite became an infant. At one moment in time, Almighty God became a human baby in a manger. Yes, Christmas this year will be different, but that's okay. Listen, many have posted this picture that you'll see now on Facebook in recent days. And it says, the first Christmas was pretty simple. It's okay if yours is too. The first Christmas surprised everybody. May Christmas 2020 do the same in a wonderful and unique and blessed way for you.
Absolutely. We're going to see the retelling of the story found in Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. Some quails, some small birds will help us. And listen out for their voices. It's cannon and ball. And then you'll see a video of the Salvation Army working and serving others this Christmas time as Shaking Stephen sings Merry Christmas, everyone. And then Mark will share with us something, a thought about bananas.
Yeah.
Really?
I will, yeah.
Okay. But first, let's see what kind of day Mary is having.
Right, that's it. He's got another 5 minutes, and if he doesn't shoo after that, I'll...
You'll what?
I'll go and find him and eat him for breakfast.
Oh, that should be entertaining.
Hey, has he gone?
Has who gone?
That bald, ugly fellow with no front teeth and bad breath.
What are you talking about?
Oh, never mind.
What's that?
Breakfast?
Breakfast?
That is a prize fig.
That is a wrinkled up old prune.
Do you mind? I've lost half my tail feathers nicking that.
Well, that would explain it, since that's where you keep your brain.
It's not that wrinkled.
Which is more than I can say for you two.
Where are you going?
I've had enough of this. Someone's got to get breakfast.
There you are. I was beginning to think you weren't coming. You're in luck. I've been baking. Hello, more of you. I'd better get some more bread.
You've done this before.
Whatever gives you that idea?
So, which one's your boyfriend?
Get off! That's my bit!
How you going to like it?
Because I had it first!
You never did! Anyway, you know how much I like the crust!
Give it to me!
No, it's mine!
Get off!
Will you two pack it in?
Not until I get my crust!
It's not your crust, it's my crust! Now let go!
Wait, wait.
Fancy a bit of crust?
Don't just sit there, get him out!
Hello, Mary.
What is that?
Shh! How do you know my name? What do you want?
Don't look so worried. I'm Gabriel. God sent me, and he's got a surprise for you.
Would someone like to tell me what the bright fish is going on?
Shh! You're going to have a baby. A little boy. You're to call him Jesus. He's the Son of God, and will be a king to his people.
But I can't give birth to a king. I'm promised to Joseph. I'm going to marry him.
Have faith, Mary. Nothing is impossible with God.
Then I am the Lord's servant. Let it be so.
Is he still there?
I'll tell you what, I've seen some weird things in my time, but that, all that glowing, it's not normal.
Of course it's not normal, you gangling great goose. That was an angel. Do you really think he came from God?
Yes, I do.
So, you're a bit of a dark horse, aren't you? How long have you been sneaking in there for breakfast?
And how long have you had your foot in your mouth?
What?
She's worried, can't you see? Now's not the time. She'll be all right, you know, Mary. You heard the angel. God's chosen her for this, so he's not going to leave her. And I bet this Joseph's a real good bloke. Hey, he'll look after her.
That's right. He'll look after her, the way we look after you.
Snow is falling. Parties, celebrations, people dancing all night long. Time for presents and exchanging wishes. Time for singing Christmas songs. We're gonna have a party tonight.
That video showed the kind of work and ministry that goes on in the Salvation Army in all kinds of places by all kinds of people who quietly, without a song and dance, just show some love in action. And that story of Mary and the angel and the quails, wow, fantastic, wasn't it? So, Christmas, bananas, and angels. What's the link? Well, do you like bananas? I do. I loved crushed bananas on toast and grilled. That's lovely. Have you ever tried that? You can put some sugar on it too. A banana ice cream sundae. That's lovely, isn't it too? Or a banana and chicken curry, like the one Jacob, one of our young junior soldiers from our fellowship, showed us on our Facebook Foodie Friday page back in the summer. But I'll let you into a secret. Above all, I like bananas barbecued. Did you know you could do that? You can cut the banana and you can open it up and put chocolate, like a flake, inside it. Then put it in tin foil and cook it on the barbecue for about 5 to 10 minutes. And then when you open it up and you've got melted chocolate inside, you can also put some marshmallows. It's wonderful. And of course, it's one of your five a day. So it works wonders, doesn't it? But did you know what happens when you cut a banana in half and you look in the middle? Well, I'll show you. And if you're trying this at home, be careful with a knife. When you cut the banana in half like that, and then you look at the seeds in the middle, and as they darken, you'll see gradually appearing an angel. Yeah? Can you see that? I've got one I prepared earlier here in good Blue Peter style. Have a look at that one. Can you see it? As the seeds have darkened, you see the body of the angel, you see the arms, you see the wings, and you see the halo as well. In every banana, there's a hidden angel. So that's the link between bananas and angels. Now then, I believe in angels, not just because Robbie Williams sang about them, but I believe in angels because I believe the Bible is true. And they tell us and they show us that angels exist. And they feature in stories like the one we've heard today. But I also believe that you and I can be hidden angels, like those in the banana. What do I mean? Well, let me tell you something that happened to me when I was 17, 18. I was working in the city of London. I was a travel agent for the Salvation Army. And I was working late on a Friday evening, till quite late, till about 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock at night. And it was in the winter time, so the nights were dark. And I got on the train and it was rather late. And I had to travel from Mansion House Station in London all the way through to Dagenham East, where I lived, on the District Line, for those of you who know the London Underground. That means going to a station called Mile End. And all those years ago that I'm talking about, Mile End was quite a dangerous place, and there was always something kicking off at the station late at night. Now, I was wearing my suit, and on my suit, on the lapel, I had a little cross, symbolic of a Christian faith. I sat down late at night on the train next to a lady. Guess what happened? The lady looked at me and then she said, are you a Christian? She'd seen the cross. And I said, yes, I am. And she said, oh, thank goodness for that. She said, I've been working late for the Samaritans. I don't usually work this late. And the one thing that I was really scared of was traveling home late through London on the Underground on my own. So she said, this morning, I prayed. And I prayed that the Lord would send a hidden angel to keep me safe. Friends, I was that angel. I was in the right place at the right time, in the right moment. And in that moment, on the Underground in London, heaven and earth connected. The highest and the high street came together as God used me in that moment, like he does you in moments when you're in the right place at the right time. As we become hidden angels. That's what you are. And God uses us to reach out to others, to care, to show love, to show compassion, and to cheer someone on and just to be with them at the right time. In fact, in that moment, they feel better about themselves, better about life, and better, I hope, about faith. Because of you and because of me, the hidden angels. Friends, whenever angels appear in the Bible, they often say two things. They say, fear not, and they say, go and do something. You check that out in the Bible. Angels say, fear not. And I'm told that actually fear not is in the Bible 365 times so that we can remember it every day of the year. And they also say, get up and go, do something, try it. They bring comfort and they bring challenge. So friends, remember angels whenever you're eating a banana, whether it's grilled, in a curry, or barbecued. And continue to ask God to use you like a hidden angel to bless others and to be just in the right place at the right time, saying and doing the right thing for God. Someone once said that music is well said to be the speech of angels. So let's together from our homes connect with the angels as we sing A Starry Night, written by Major Joy Webb many years ago now and has become so popular over the years, not least in schools and in assemblies and in carol services all over England and indeed the world. And then after this, the Archangel Andrea is going to share another thought with you today. Let's sing A Starry Night.
Prophet Isaiah. spoken over 600 years before Jesus was born in that barn in Bethlehem. He was preparing the way for Jesus when he wrote, "The people walking in the darkness have seen a great light, for unto us a child is born." He was foretelling, he was bringing vision and insight. And talking of sight, I shared with Essence that a few months ago I realised that my eyesight was deteriorating. I was having to hold papers closer to my face and at times realised that I just couldn't see the words. So off I went to the opticians, and that in itself was an experience. Having to try on glasses wearing a mask was not easy. And then every pair that you touched had to be put in a box and then cleaned. I'm not sure I was very popular with the staff as I tried on so many pairs of glasses. But now I can see more clearly. What was a blur is now clear. And the anxiety about not being able to see clearly has now gone. Now the glasses haven't changed what I see. It has just become bigger. And spiritually, what we magnify really matters, friends. We need to magnify just how good God is and how faithful he is. We need to magnify what he has done for us. And friends, those tough times, those seasons of testing, for example, are the times to magnify like never before just how good God is. To magnify just how faithful he has been in our life. Psalm 34 has to be one of my favourite psalms at the moment, and particularly from the Passion Translation. It reads, "Lord, I'm bursting with joy over what you've done for me. My lips are full of perpetual praise. I'm boasting of you and all your works. So let all who are discouraged take heart. Join me, everyone. Let's praise the Lord together. Let's make him famous. Let's make his name glorious to all." I love that translation. Friends, what we magnify is what will be amplified, and it will either speak of who he is or of our problems. Yes, what we face at times has its challenges, absolutely, but what we magnify is what we will champion. So what are you magnifying? What is getting the magnification treatment in your world, your life, right now? Are you magnifying the problem, or are you magnifying the answer? What right now is getting your focus? Friends, wrong magnification will mean that we may miss the blessings. But with the right magnification, we will see just how great God is, and blessings will flow, and we will see possibilities. Mary is a great example to us all. She's told that she will have a child. She would have been scared and anxious and afraid. But she finds it in her heart to magnify the Lord. We read in Luke chapter 1 verse 46, Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour." I love that verse of scripture. A young boy came home from Sunday school and was asked by his mum what he had learned. And he told her that when Mary heard that she was the mother of Jesus, she sang the Magna Carta. He'd misheard. But friends, Mary did magnify the Lord in that moment. And if Mary can magnify God in her most confusing moments, then surely we can choose to magnify what matters to us, and yes, for future generations. St. Francis of Assisi said, and this is for everyone, regardless of our age or gender, he said, "We are the mother of Christ when we carry him in our heart and body by love and a pure and sincere conscience. And we give birth to him through holy works, which ought to shine on others by our example." Now there's a thought. Friends, Christmas tells us once and for all that God is not above us or against us, but among us. The infinite became an infant. The Almighty God became a baby. An angel told Mary she would have a child. And Mary's response, I'm sure, was a mixture of disbelief, questions, trust, and fear. But she thanks God and she magnifies her Lord. She made sure that he was big in her life, and she focused on him more than anything and anything else. May we do the same, and may this unusual, different, simpler Christmas help us to do the same. Be encouraged and be blessed as Ruth brings a reading to us just now, and then listen and receive a blessing as Charlie Green sings.
Dear Joseph, I had a dream, Joseph. I don't understand it, not really, but I think it was about a birthday celebration for our son. I think that was what it was all about. The people had been preparing for it for about 8 weeks. They had decorated the house and bought new clothes. They'd gone shopping many times and bought elaborate gifts. It was peculiar though, because the presents weren't for our son. They wrapped them in beautiful paper and tied them with lovely bows and stacked them under a tree. Yes, a tree, Joseph, right in their house. They decorated the tree too. The branches were full of glowing baubles and sparkling ornaments. There was a figure on the top of the tree. It looked like an angel might look. Oh, it was beautiful. Everyone was laughing and happy. They were excited about the gifts. They gave gifts to each other, Joseph, not to our son. I don't think they even knew him. They never mentioned his name. Doesn't it seem odd for people to go to all that trouble to celebrate someone's birthday if they don't know him? I had the strangest feeling that if our son had gone to this celebration, he would have been intruding. Everything was so beautiful, Joseph, and everyone so full of cheer. But it made me want to cry. How sad for Jesus not to be wanted at his own birthday celebration. I'm glad it was only a dream. How terrible, Joseph, if it had been real. Love and prayers, Mary.
Bless us and keep us. May the Lord smile on us, shine his light upon us. And may the turn his face towards us, give us his peace, give us his peace.
That was a really helpful time, wasn't it, to set the scene for our Advent season together. And thanks for that lovely thought, Andrea. That was really helpful too. And I love that quote from St. Francis of Assisi. Now, he was the first person to come up with the idea of enacting out and depicting the Nativity. Did you know that?
I did.
Yeah, I thought you did. Yeah, going right back to 1223, he came up with this idea to get people to dress up and to bring to life this incredible story. And ever since then, it's been happening all over the world in different ways and in different cultures. It's wonderful.
Advent is a journey. It's an adventure.
See what you did there?
That's an good adventure.
Yeah.
With its ups and downs, with its twists and its turns, with its joys and pains, and with its hopes and fears. And on this journey, this adventure, which encompasses the whole of life, we pray that we will each know the presence of the one who is the King of Kings, the Saviour of the world, Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, God with us.
And to help you, friends, during our Advent time, we've attached with this video an Advent alphabet focus. It's daily devotions for you to share in from now until Boxing Day. And we're very grateful to Major Gethin Thomas, who is a Corps officer in Pentra, for preparing that for us. And that will be a helpful blessing, I'm sure, knowing that we're all sharing that together as we journey through Advent.
And friends, tonight is our next Zoom worship time here for our fellowship at Norwich Citadel. It will be at 4:30 and all the login details have been sent to you. For the creative time together, we ask you to hold up a Christmas decoration or an ornament or a nativity piece or a picture as we start this Advent season together.
Those times are very special, yeah, aren't they? As we see each other from our fellowship. And talking of people in our fellowship, we do thank Joyce Youngman for making this Advent wreath. There's a team of ladies who decorate our hall beautifully, and it really comes to life at Christmas with that. So thank you, Joyce. And this will feature throughout the Advent season. Zoom worship. I love it. Friends, as the angels zoomed overhead at Bethlehem 2,000 years ago, they declared, they proclaimed the good news of Jesus Christ, as we have today. Do you remember those actions from Hark the Herald? Do you remember them? Hark the Herald, angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Go do it, as the angel would say, and don't be afraid. Keep on practicing that today. Try it out at home. And more importantly, remember that as the angels sang glory to God in the highest, that's wonderful. But we must live out glory to God in the high street, in the everydayness of our lives.
Friends, may we have the privilege of praying with you this wonderful Christmas blessing as you look at a picture of the Nativity. And then we'll see and hear the song, Rejoice, Rejoice, Christ is in you. Mary rejoiced, and may we do the same. Let's pray together.
May the joy of the angels.
May the obedience of Mary and Joseph.
May the eagerness of the shepherds.
May the perseverance of the wise men.
And may the peace of Jesus Christ be with you now, this Christmas, and forevermore. Amen.
Goodbye, friends.
Remember, you're a hidden angel. Let's magnify and rejoice together.
Bye.